Hello friends, welcome to the YouTube show Health Cue, where our aim is to motivate you to look at the brighter side of your health and start working towards it. Today, it's an indeed pleasure for me because we have got with us Dr. Natraj HM. He is a consultant orthopedic surgeon and knee and shoulder specialist from Sakra World Hospital, Bangalore. Welcome, sir. Welcome to the show.
Good morning, Dr. Meghana. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you. So, sir, what in our channel we try to do is to try raise awareness about different health topics among people. And couple of months back, I made some couple of videos around knee joint. And to my surprise, there were so many questions that people had, so many comments were there. So we literally decided, okay, we need to put some more light into this topic. And that's why I have got some couple of questions for you from our audience itself, which I'm going to ask you. First question that I want to ask you, so is it really that knee pain is too common these days?
Yeah, among the patients whom I see in my OPD, one-third of the patients whom I see in orthopedic OPD are knee patients.
Okay.
So that means it's a lot. It's a lot. Around one-third of my patients are knee patients.
Right.
So, and generally people ask me, why knee pain is so common?
Right.
So to get deeper into it, knee is almost considered like a wheel of a tire of a car or a two-wheeler, mm-hmm. where the whole stress of the vehicle goes on that. Similarly, the each movement we move, each step we take, there is a toss on the knee joint. This makes the knee more prone for the pain and injury. There are a lot of causes for knee pain. It can be a simple nutritional deficiency like vitamin D deficiency can cause a knee pain. Something like other nutritious things like gout can cause knee pain. Or maybe in severe conditions, something like an arthritis can cause knee pain. Osteoarthritis can cause knee pain. Apart from some injuries like ligament tears, meniscal tears, and even a simple tendinitis, bursitis. If I start naming it, the list goes very long.
Correct. So there are multitude of conditions that could lead to knee pain, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, sir, which is a common age group which you see in your experience are more prone to develop knee pain?
Knee pain can happen in any age group. I mean, I see knee pain in kids, I see knee pain in younger adults, I see knee pain in elderly. Among this, knee pain is more common in elderly.
Right.
So the elderly, the knee pain is more because of wear and tear, that is age-related wear and tear of the knee joint.
Okay. So sir, can you tell me what are those conditions that different age groups are more prone?
Yeah. In the kids, more commonly because of injury, a small fall, and sometimes it can be because of nutritional. In a young, fit, active patient who is physically very active in them, the most common thing is vitamin D deficiency, which I see day in, day out. And among the younger population, the alcohol is one of the favorite things which is happening now. So the increased alcohol intake can predispose a person to gout, which can cause knee pain. Apart from that, another group, they're the lazy group. So they don't exercise, the muscle group will be weak. So this can also cause knee pain.
Okay.
This is in the younger age group. In an elderly age group, that is 50, 60 plus age group, in them the most common cause of knee pain is osteoarthritis, that is age-related wear and tear of the knee joint.
So sir, when it comes to arthritis, people kind of relate arthritis with knee.
Yes.
Because it's not necessary, arthritis can affect other joints as well. So can you just explain to a patient what exactly the term arthritis means?
Yeah. Arthritis means any inflammation happening in a joint is called arthritis, which leads to pain. So it's a common question among my patients is, they ask me, what is inflammation? So inflammation is nothing but hyper-responsiveness of body's immune system against its own structure. Inflammation can be on the skin, inflammation can be in the brain, inflammation can be in the stomach, inflammation can be in a joint. When this inflammation happens in a joint, we use the word arthritis. There are multiple causes of arthritis. If you start counting, if I want to give a number, around 200 types of arthritis which is known to mankind. Among that, the most common is age-related arthritis, that is simple wear and tear of the knee joint. That's called as osteoarthritis.
So, sir, there are many people who also experience arthritic changes early in their life.
Yes.
Many people try kind of correlate it with chondromalacia patellae,
yes,
the condition.
Yes.
So, is arthritis and chondromalacia patellae the same? Or it is kind of two different things.
Yeah. So the early arthritis, as I told, osteoarthritis is nothing but wear and tear of a knee joint. Wear and tear generally happens in an elderly age group. Generally in Indian population, it's a 40 plus age group. But it can happen in a younger age group, which is a secondary to an injury or a neglected ligament tear or a meniscal tear. So when, I'll just explain with this a small model. This is a model of a knee joint. This is the lower end of the thigh bone. This is the upper end of the leg bone, which together articulates and form a joint. In the front, there is kneecap or patella. So these three structures together constitutes a knee joint. With age and with age, with wear and tear, with repeated movement and repeated stress on the knee joint, the knee goes for wear and tear. The most commonly, the inner compartment, the inner part, that is, this part is more prone for wear and tear. So this is a common feature what we see in early osteoarthritis. Many times this is, and sometimes as a part of wear and tear, it can happen in the patella as well, that is kneecap bone as well, which is also a feature of osteoarthritis. But the isolated patellofemoral arthritis, that is isolated arthritis of the or wear and tear of the kneecap bone, is called as chondromalacia patella. The most common cause of chondromalacia patella is the tracking of the patella. Whenever we bend our knee, the patella, the kneecap bone, moves in a particular fashion over the rest of the knee joint. Sometimes the alignment changes. Instead of moving this way, it moves this way. So this is the most common cause of chondromalacia patella. So that is, the lack of alignment of the kneecap bone is a cause of chondromalacia patella, not just the wear and tear. There's two are entirely different terminologies. The chondromalacia patella can happen in association with early osteoarthritis, or it can happen in isolation due to alignment issues.
So now let's talk in more detail about arthritis, because that's again a very common question and common condition. What's the ideal solution for osteoarthritis?
Yeah, so the osteoarthritis, I mean, I hope you're asking about the treatment of osteoarthritis. Right. The osteoarthritis, generally I divide the osteoarthritis in treating as early osteoarthritis and the late osteoarthritis. Right. So treatment entirely depends on the arthritis, a patient, the stage the patient is in.
Correct.
So in early arthritis, the main aim of treatment is to prevent the further wear and tear, and of course to relieve the pain.
Correct.
So to prevent the further wear and tear, certain do's and don'ts are followed. The first thing is exercise. So strengthen the muscles around the thigh bone. So the muscles itself acts as a shock absorber. Once the muscles are strong, it absorbs the stress which is going to the knee joint and prevent the further wear and tear. So exercise is a very important part of treatment of early osteoarthritis. The second is, of course, the stress can also be because of weight. So weight loss definitely helps in reducing the further worsening of osteoarthritis. Then there are some medicines which can temporarily relieve pain, that is a simple painkiller medications which can relieve pain at the phase of increased pain. So generally osteoarthritis, the pain is not a constant. If you want to draw it as a curve, it's in peaks, multiple peaks. When the pain increases, that the particular few days patients require some sort of pain medications which can relieve the pain, and then pain automatically comes down. Apart from this, there are some injections available. They're called as visco supplementation. It is a jelly-like or a grease-like substance which we inject inside the knee joint. By virtue of its thick substance, it acts as a shock absorber and prevents further wear and tear. Plus, it has a content called as hyaluronate, which provides nutrition to the remaining cartilage and prevents further wear and tear.
I get this question asked by a lot of patients who comes to me for osteoarthritis, early osteoarthritis especially. They say that after 10 years or maybe after 5 years, do we really need to go for knee replacement surgery? Is there a way that we can avoid that?
Yeah. So knee replacement surgery is just to improve the quality of life. This is not a surgery where, unlike the heart surgery, brain surgery, this is not done to save life. So according to, in my view, knee replacement is not must. So a person with a very bad pain, unable to do his day-to-day routines, or where the requirement of painkillers is too high, causing the other internal damage to kidneys or liver, in those patients, it's better to consider knee replacement. But since you asked, is it must?
Right.
It's never a must.
Okay.
Knee replacement is just another modality of treatment, and it's not the only modality of treatment to cure osteoarthritis.
So, sir, the last question, what is the advice that you would like to give to the viewers who are watching, who are either going through arthritis right now in a very bad phase or are in early stage? What is the one general advice you can say you would like to give them?
Yeah. So, first, let me start with people who do not have arthritis but who have fear of getting arthritis. Let me start from there. So, people in a young population who don't want to get arthritis, first let me explain. There are risk factors for anything. There is, generally, we explain it in the terms, based in risk factors. There are certain modifiable risk factors. There are certain non-modifiable risk factors. Non-modifiable risk factors are genetics, which we already born with it. Right now, with the today's science, I mean, whatever we have advanced, we don't have something to change the genes till now. So if I carry a gene which causes osteoarthritis, it's a non-modifiable, nothing can be done with that. But I have another big chunk which are modifiable risk factors, which I can work on that and prevent or delay the onset of osteoarthritis. The one is, of course, as I said earlier, exercise. Keeping the thigh muscle strong, keeping the bulk of the muscle better, which can prevent the which can reduce the stress on the knee joint and prevent osteoarthritis. Second, of course, a chuck in the weight. The high body weight can predispose the knee to a lot of stress. Suppose if a person is 50 kg, other person is 100 kg, he puts twice the stress on knee joint with every step he takes. With millions of steps we take in every day. So the stress doubles up. So this is a definite risk factor for osteoarthritis. And third, early treatment of injuries. Something like a ligament injuries, a meniscal injuries, or a small fractures, many times it can go unnoticed. With early and appropriate treatment of such injuries, such smaller injuries, can prevent the onset of osteoarthritis. And of course, fourth thing is nutrition. Keep the bones strong with a good vitamin D and calcium rich food and with regular exercises. These are modifiable risk factors. By working on a modifiable risk factors, we can delay the onset and of course prevent osteoarthritis. And non-modifiable risk factors, genes which we don't have any control. This is for the younger age group who are scared of getting osteoarthritis. Now the next group comes, that is people with osteoarthritis, that is already who are in 40s, 50s, already who have osteoarthritis. In early stages, as I explained in the previous question, simple regular exercises, a morning walk, nutrition, I mean, concentrating on nutrition, and reducing the stress on the knee, that's very important. So reducing stress in the knee is not important in the people who do not have arthritis, but this is very important in the people with arthritis. That is, we can reduce the stress in the knee joint by avoiding squatting, that is indent sitting in the indent type toilet, cross-leg sitting, kneeling, and stair climbing. These are the activities which increase the stress on the knee joint, which predisposes the knee to further wear and tear, or the wear and tear accelerates very fast. Instead of taking 10-15 years to get into from early arthritis to severe arthritis, it can happen in 5 years. So these things to be avoided. In people with already full-blown osteoarthritis, already severe osteoarthritis with knees bent, so what has to be done? So you should check what are the activities you are unable to do, what are the lifestyle or what are the quality of life which is altered. So if somebody who is unable to even do his day-to-day activities, little bit of a morning walk of even a little bit of walking of 100 meters is difficult, they are the patient who has to consider total knee replacement. Here, worn out cartilage is just shaved off, a cap-like structure, I'll just explain with this model. Knee replacement is a surgery where a worn out cartilage, that is damaged cartilage and damaged part of the knee joint, is just shaved and trimmed. It's not, I mean, contrary to the common belief that knee replacement is they cut the whole knee and put an artificial knee. It's nothing like that. Only the damaged wear and worn off cartilage is shaved and an artificial implant is placed. This is like a cap. It's not a, we don't cut the knee and put an artificial knee, we just cap the knee so that when we start moving, so we move on an artificial joint so that there'll be no pain, and of course this improves the mobility. So this is the first group of patients. This is the other group of patients who can comfortably walk for a kilometer, who can do most of his day-to-day routines. So in them, there is no need of knee replacement. So knee replacement is not a must surgery. Absolutely, if you can walk for a kilometer comfortably, there is absolutely don't consider knee replacement, irrespective of the deformity which you have. So this is second thing. And third thing, of course, avoid stress in the knee joint, and regular exercises, they're very important to prevent further wear and tear. I mean, already worn off, and to prevent further wear and tear, regular exercises are required. And in a late stages where a patient is not fit for surgery, always use a walking stick. The knee replacement is the most common cause of fall causing a spine fracture, hip fracture or knee fracture. So always take a support, a walking stick or a walker to prevent falls.
So one more last question. Just when you said exercises, right? Exercise regularly. Here you mean to say and focused exercise for your quadriceps strengthening, mm-hmm. or it is an overall general well-being exercise? What kind of exercise?
Yes, this is a very good question. So there are set of exercises a person with osteoarthritis can do it. So you can meet any of your physiotherapist, so who can teach you all the set of exercises. So there are simple exercises. They mainly exercises to strengthen the quadriceps, strengthen the abductors of the hip, extensors of the hip joint. It's very difficult to explain in this video. You can meet your doctor or a physiotherapist who can teach you exercises, get trained and continue doing at home regularly.
Thank you so much, sir. It was indeed a very useful session for me as well. I also learned a lot of things from you. And guys, sir is my go-to person. If I have any doubts related to orthopedics or if I have got any patients where I have some doubts, sir is always there to help. I would highly recommend you guys to follow his handle. He has his own page on Facebook.
Knee and Shoulder.
And he also has a YouTube channel, Knee and Shoulder. Mm-hmm. So please go and subscribe to his channel. And he has mentioned a very nice article he has written on what stage you should go for knee osteoarthritis. It's there in our Health Awareness magazine. The link is mentioned in the description box. You can download that magazine for free and read that article. It's a must read, guys. So thank you so much, sir. Thank you for having us on the show. So guys, see you next week. And if you have got any questions related to knee joint, please mention in the comment section below. And don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends and family whom you feel this video would be helpful, and subscribe to this channel. See you on another video. Bye bye.